Namaste children. Yes, have you all done your homework? Hope you have done. But as far as my knowledge, only few children have sent me the pics of their homework. But others, they did not do. Why do you think they did not do? Because they are ... They may be lazy, they may be not interested in the subject, or they may feel that okay, later we will do. Yes, everyone has their own opinion. But when the homework is given, you people will have some fear in your mind and you wish to do that, but you feel it as a tiresome job. It's an unpleasant thing. Though it is an unpleasant thing, we will give the homework and some or other day you will complete the homework. But there are some children, they will never do their work. Like that is our Patrick. He doesn't want to do the homework. He is good at studies, but because of his laziness and because of his not interest in the subjects, he will keep on pending the work. This is how he doesn't do his homework. But somebody has helped Patrick to do the homework. Now, who is that person who has helped him to do the homework? We will see now in our lesson, who did Patrick's homework, part 1. Come on children, all of you open your English textbooks to page number 7. Page number 7. Already this we have completed in the month of April, but as to revise you, again we are going through these lessons. You go through very well, listen carefully and understand it. Okay ma? Now all of you open your English textbooks and keep a pencil with you. Wherever you find the difficult words apart from which are given in the textbook, you have to circle them. Then why you have to circle, I will tell you in the later part of the lesson. Okay children, are you all ready with your textbook? When you are starting watching the video of English subject, before you start, you keep the textbook, classwork, pencil, pen, everything ready so that you need not panic while watching the video. Yes, everyone, are you all ready, Nana? Yes, open your textbook to page number 7. Now here the lesson is, who did Patrick's homework? Patrick never did homework. Too boring, he said. He played hockey and basketball and Nintendo instead. His teachers told him, "Patrick, do your homework or you won't learn a thing." And it's true. Sometimes he did feel like an ignoramus. But what could he do? He hated homework. So Patrick, he never liked to do the homework. Why? Because he used to feel that homework is such a boring job. He never wanted to do the homework. But he loved to play hockey and basketball. He loves to play hockey and basketball. In addition to this, he used to play even Nintendo. Nintendo means it's a type of video game. As you will be having so many video games, you will be enjoying watching the video games, isn't it? In the same manner, Patrick also loves to play the video games, and when he is outside, he used to play hockey and basketball. Only the tiresome job for Patrick was doing the homework. So what teachers will say, do your homework or you won't learn a thing. Why we will give the homework, children? Do you think that we want to trouble you? No way, we never want to trouble you. Only why we will give the homework is because we wanted to revise the subject so that you can have a glance on it, you will read it and revise it and you can understand it. That is the purpose of homework. But some children, they will take it as is very easy, they will take it for granted. Okay, let's do, let's see. Simply they wanted to postpone the work. Sometimes he did feel like an ignoramus. Ignoramus means, what is the meaning of ignoramus? An ignorant person who lacks education. Sometimes he feel, arey, why should I learn? What is the use of learning? Why should I study? Why should I do the homework? All these things used to come to his mind. He used to feel that better if we are uneducated. If I don't know anything, I would have not gone to school. Like that he used to think. And it's true, sometimes he did feel like an ignoramus, but what could he do? But he is in the school, he has to do the homework, but he hated to do the homework. Now let's see how he will do, how he will continue his job, we will see in the next paragraph. Then one day he found his cat playing with a little doll and he grabbed it away. To his surprise, it wasn't a doll at all, but a man of tiniest size. He had a little wool shirt with old-fashioned breeches and a high tall hat, much like a witch. He yelled, "Save me! Don't give me back to that cat. I'll grant you a wish. I promise you that." So what happened when Patrick was sitting and he was thinking how to postpone, how to skip the homework. As he was sitting and thinking, he is making up a plan. Immediately he found his cat, pet cat, playing with a little doll. He found that something changed. Why this little cat, from where did this little cat got this doll? He wanted to see what the doll is. So he grabbed means he forcefully took the doll from the cat and then he caught it in his hand. So how he was, that was the tiniest means very small, tiniest means very small size. And how he was, though it was so small, it was wearing a wool shirt with old fashioned breeches and a high tall hat, like birthday cat cone shaped hat we will have no more, like a hat he was wearing. He was wearing the hat. And as soon as Patrick hold in his hand, he yelled. Yelled means shouted. Sharply he shouted and said, Please don't give me back to the cat. So he was so scared that when cat was playing with this little person. So he shouted and he told that, please don't give me back to the cat. I will grant you a wish. So I promise you that, please, it pleaded Patrick not to give it back to the cat. So what wish that little man is going to give to Patrick, we will see in the next paragraph. Patrick couldn't believe how lucky he was. He was the answer. Here was the answer to all of his problems. So he said, only if you do all my homework till the end of the semester. That's 35 days. If you do a good enough job, I could even get A's. So what Patrick was thinking? He was thinking, oh my God, I'm so lucky that someone has come to help me out. Actually, what was the Patrick's problem? The homework was the Patrick's problem. So he thought that, okay, now I will ask this little man to do all my homework. So what he said, here is the answer. So he said to that little man that, okay, I'm not going to give back to the cat, but I have a demand. You wanted to solve my problem. So the little man said, yes, what is it? Only thing what it was thinking, Patrick was saying that, okay, you have to do all my homework till the end of the semester. That how many days are left for the semester? 35 days were left for the semester. So Patrick gave the task to the little man that he has to complete the homework till 35 days. So if Patrick does the homework up to 35 days, Patrick is going to get all Yes, which is a very good sign for his improvement, for getting knowledge. So he felt that he gave the task to the little man that he has to complete the work, all the work, whatever, all the homework, whatever is given up to 35 days. Now let's see whether that little man agreed to do the homework or not. We'll see in the next paragraph. The little man's face wrinkled like a dishcloth thrown in the hamper. He kicked his legs and doubled his fists, and he grimaced and scowled and pursed his lips. Oh, am I cursed? But I'll do it. So the little man's face wrinkled. He was so angry, like an old man. His face was full of folds, and he kept his face like this and said that he kicked his leg. He was very angry, with great anger. What is it here? Grimaced means frown in an angry or bad tempered way. If anyone gives you one after other, if they give you without any rest, if anyone gives you work, you will get hated, you will get so disturbed, and you will go to the bad mood, and your face will change and you will become so angry. So this man was also wrinkled like a dishcloth. Dishcloth means it is a cloth used to for washing the clothes. So his face was like a dishcloth, and he kicked his legs and he doubled his fist. He became so angry, and he said that he grimaced and scowled and pursed his lips. He became so angry, he closed his lips and said, "Oh, am I cursed? But I will do it." So that little man was thinking that he was pleading Patrick not to give back to the cat. But Patrick, what he is doing? He is giving some other task to the little man. He was thinking that, am I cursed? So with great hatred, the little man agreed to do the work of Patrick. So how he is going to do the work? How he is going to take the help of Patrick? Whether the little man going to do all the work by himself, or he is going to take the help of Patrick? Let us see in our next paragraph. Yes. And true to his word, that little elf began to do Patrick's homework, except there was one glitch. The elf didn't always know what to do, and he needed help. "Help me, help me," he would say, and Patrick would have to help in whatever way. "I don't know this word," the elf squeaked while reading Patrick's homework. "Give me a dictionary." "No, what's even better, look up the word and sound it out by each letter." So now how that little man, who is that little man? Little man is nothing but the elf. Elf means who is having some magical powers. They can do the work, any type of work, by themselves. So here that little man is nothing but it is an elf, and it was trying to do the work of Patrick. And let's see how, what he is saying. He is trying to do the work, but how he is doing, let us see now. So what he is saying, and true to his word, that little elf began to do part. He accepted to do the work, so it started doing the homework. But there was one glitch. So glitch means something trouble. If any work is going on without any trouble, nothing, it goes on peacefully, smoothly it will go. But if any problem comes in between, so what we will do? We have to put an end to that problem to do the work smoothly. So here the elf, he was trying to do the homework, but there was a glitch. What was it? The elf didn't always know what to do, and he needed the assistance of Patrick. So the elf, he don't know anything. He knows everything, but it wants the help of Patrick. So that elf didn't always know what to do, and he needed help. "Help me, help me," he would say. So always, though elf promised to do the homework of Patrick, but he was sitting beside and he was shouting and he was saying, help me, help me. So what? And Patrick would have to help. So though the work was given to the elf, Patrick was not relaxed. The elf didn't make Patrick to relax. He was taking, now he was taking the help of Patrick by asking him to tell the meanings of the words. And how he used to say, please, I don't know the meaning of this word. You bring the dictionary, you open the thesaurus, you open and tell me what is the meaning. I am an elf, I don't know what is this English language. I don't know the nature of human beings. Please get me a dictionary. And also it used to say that I cannot read the words. You read for me word to word. You tell me the meaning. Then I will do it. In this way, the elf took the help of Patrick. And Patrick also read for help. Elf thinking that the elf is doing the homework. So in this manner, elf started doing the homework of Patrick.
Yes, children, have you all understood till here?
Yes, now here I have written the meanings. You need not worry about the meanings on the board. But I have given you, along with this video link, I will be sending you the PDF docs. There I have given you the meanings and also I have given the questions. So you have to, in the classwork, you have to write down the lesson name, part 1, and meanings you write down. And along with this, I have added some more thing also for you. As when you open the PDF, then you will be knowing. I have given you 4 questions. You write down the question and write the answer for that. After writing one question and answer, leave one line. Then you write down the second question. Same way you follow. When we do this part 2, then you can continue from there. Thank you, Nana.